tear gas, a curfew and an internet shutdown. These are the latest measures taken by Indian authorities in Manipur following protests yesterday. They say that protesters are using social media to spread misinformation, fueling a continuation of violence in the area.
We will be taking actions against those who have indulged in excesses. We are taking screenshots. When someone just spread a false kind of a message, those kind of things create panic and those kind of things create confusion.
A state of 3.2 million people, Manipur on India's eastern border has been divided into two ethnic enclaves. A valley controlled by the mostly Hindu Maithai community makes up five districts, while 11 districts in the surrounding hills are dominated by the ethnic Christian group, the Kukis. An area of no man's land monitored by federal paramilitary forces separates the feuding tribes. The unrest began in May of last year when the Kukis protested a demand by the Maithais for special status, allowing them to buy land in the hills and fill quotas in jobs and colleges. At least 9 people have been killed and several more injured in the past 10 days. Homes and vehicles also destroyed as armed groups launched drone attacks and rockets from homemade devices. Yesterday, demonstrators protested against the fresh wave of ethnic violence. They were tear gassed and dispersed by police.
This particular is mainly to give the information to the concerned authorities that there is no difference between living in a cage and living in the Ifal Valley. There is no sort of safety zone right now.
220 people have been killed and over 60,000 displaced in the last year in Manipur over this, the right to buy land. Two communities who previously lived in harmony, now locked in conflict, with no resolution in sight. Mihalo Skanal, SBS World News.